Yes, 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 yes. This is the moment we have been waiting for. Myself, I'm hungry. I know someone is hungry. I want to know if you are online right now. We have just hit the airways. This is Facebook Live. I must break through. Wherever you are around the world, please, we want to know if you are following because we have so much to do tonight. So much, so much, so much. And I want you to come online right now. Wake up, wake up, wake up. And wherever you are, let us know if you are following. We want to know if you are following because there's something God is about to do tonight that is going to change your life. Wherever you are, invite your friends right now. Tell them Paula Dokame is live on Facebook. Start inviting them right now, right now, right now. Ele beng bong, bile bong, bege bubo. Bing bing bong bong, balak beng bong, beg bing bing bong bong bong. Billy bong bong, Billy bong bong, Billy bong bong. Belu bu beg, beli bag, beg 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 bong bong bong. Bele boom ba ba ba. E Billy bong bong. Bang bang bong bong, bang bang bong bong ba. Dili bi bu bu. Bali bu de be di bu de be du be. Billy bo bo be, Billy bi be bu be be be. E bolo bong bong. Yes, 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 yes. The Holy Ghost right now is telling me that there are people whose lives will be changed tonight via this broadcast. So wherever you are, we want to know if you are following or because this is midnight in Zimbabwe. La broda baledo, zubrede de bosata. Yes, the Bible says, and it shall come to pass. This is the night. This is the night. It shall come to pass. It shall come to pass. It shall come to pass. Le molodiga bond. E brebo dula badenda galabodaba. Le krubudu galibo yabada. Balete. Wherever you are, it is time to pray. 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 It is Paul Adokame live on Facebook. Elegula bayanda bra. Zuke di balakosa balatuta. Brende lika baladudu zaga balataya. Le brogoto balige. Duza balaga dudu bregedula bayatoto. Ziki debele gudu braga de gedula bayagudu galaba. Please, we want to test if you are following, if we are on live. Please, check it out. Check it out. Are we on live? Yes, it's a serious matter right now. It's a serious matter. So, I'm still trying to connect. Are you connecting, Pastor Joshua? Yes, 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 yes. I want us to be sure that you are following because we want to give you something very, very important. Yes, yes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes. We are about to hit the purpose while we are here tonight. Something is happening. Something is happening. Something is happening. I want to know if you are there. Okay, you are there. They're telling me someone already coming up right now. God has a word for somebody. Ah! I must break through. Wherever you are right now, I want to see anger in your spirit. Because it is, I must break through. The powers fighting your breakthroughs are in trouble tonight. The powers fighting your breakthroughs are in trouble tonight. Agabali dobolata. We are speaking in tongues for 1 minute, wherever you are right now, around the world. For 1 minute, go ahead and pray in tongues. And if you can't pray in tongues, be shouting Jesus, 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 Jesus. Baleto, Zidege, Paledia, Menunu, Zivigaduda, Belete Duya, Ibade, Dede, Patolodosh, Ligide, De, 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 Bele Bongo, Ibongo, Ibongo, Billy Buddha Bada, I take over the airways right now by the power of the Holy Ghost. Liba Ligududu De, I speak to the east, north, west, south, right now. Beligudu, open up for the breakthroughs of God's people. Leguluzu Baleti, I release angels all over the world. Ba de dudu de baligudu ya de de zigi de ba de ludu de de maligude yamana mono hosata. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. Yes, thank you, Holy Spirit. 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 I'm seeing doors opening tonight. Yes, I'm seeing doors right now. I can see doors. There are people connected to this broadcast tonight. Within 24 hours, there shall be good news coming to them. from everywhere. Oh God, thank you. Now, in Genesis chapter 38, we have begun. Shabalagadaba. The Holy Ghost is on me right now. Lubre de la Hamamadeka. Budu belebedu dabalaguyama nehete. In Genesis chapter 38, Abaludu degede. Ningbelek budu bedebuyamanda. Everywhere you are, listen to me. Something is about to happen. In verse 29, the scripture says, and it came to pass, as he drew back his hand, that behold, his brother came out. And she said, how has that broken forth? This breach be upon thee. Therefore, his name was called Phares. Tonight, it is Phares night. I must break through. The word Phares means breakthrough, division, penetrating through hard ground to break forth in life and destiny. It is a journey of aggression. Tonight, anywhere they are sitting on your breakthrough, on your destiny, there shall be thunder, earthquake, and lightning tonight. In your villages, in your communities, in your father houses, your mother houses, I am out tonight as AK-87 under the power of the Holy Ghost, connected to my spiritual father, Apostle John Suleiman, to cause earthquake in your communities. Wherever they are sitting on what belongs to you, there shall be tsunami tonight by the power of the Holy Ghost. The scripture says two destinies were coming. Two. And one of them was out to fulfill destiny that the parents could not. And that is Phares. And the other is called Zarah. Hear me well, that you are not alone in that family. You were born with others. But hear me, you are not like them. And they are not like you. There's something about you that they are intimidated and threatened about. And I want to tell you that we are dealing with household enemies tonight. Are they following? Something is happening. My spirit is here. Because some people's destinies have been oppressed too long. They are sitting on you, but you are in the city, but in the village. They are deliberating and manipulating your destiny. We are dealing with satanic manipulation tonight. La bande de palette. I shake the powers of your father's house. I shake the powers of your mother's house. I shake the powers that have been in your community that stagnate and limit destinies. I shatter them tonight. But the power of the Holy Ghost, wherever you are right now, speak in tongues. If you can't be shouting Jesus in 30 seconds, it is war tonight. Pale. I must break through. In life and destiny, in ministry, in deep business, in politics, I must break through. Wherever you are, I release angels to you right now. In the name of Jesus. God just spoke to me. He said, son, I am opening doors for people tonight. There are doors opening by force. There are two ways to enter your room. Enter with a key or by breaking the door. Tonight, wherever your doors have been shut, we are breaking through them tonight. The scripture says, as soon as Zarah withdrew his hand, a destiny came breaking forth. And who was that? Is for us. Tonight, Kelebo Shatabaha, that evil hand that has prevented someone from coming out, that evil hand is catching fire tonight. Any evil hand that is fighting, manipulating, truncating your destiny, your helpers, fighting you from rising, tonight, with the sword of the Holy Ghost, I cut them off. There are some people in your villages that will be heartless after tonight. The Holy Ghost will take off their hands. Whatever they are using to manipulate you out of destiny, the fire of God will come on them tonight. I speak as a messenger of God. Wherever you are right now connected, hear me well. This is not a form. We are not catching some form. This is not entertainment. This is midnight in Zimbabwe. And we are dealing with powers because as from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffers violence. And the violent take it by force. Don't sleep. Wake up. This is the time to be angry. Let me see anger in your eyes. Don't try to doze. Don't slumber.
others fail in your family? Because no one could take the challenge like this. Do you know why others have gone up and they came down? Because no one could wake up like this at such a time as this. This is your season. This is your time. It's time to say failure no more. Oppression no more. Witches and wizards, lizards in your communities that have stagnated people and destinies for years. It is time to quit them. It is time to flush them out. Now, I want you to pray right now. In 30 seconds, focus this prayer on your family. Any wicked power in my home, fighting my rising, die. Open your mouth. Every wicked power in my father's house, in my mother's house, fighting my rising, die, die, die. There are angels who hold these words, and as they hear you pray along with me tonight, they shall go into oppression. Pray the prayer. Any wicked power fighting my rising, mele gudu yapa, de gili gabatosh, da, in the name of Jesus. Now, before I begin to, you know, the Lord and that said the word, as we pray, there's a woman, right now you are listening, you are watching this. It's a woman I'm seeing. You have suffered so many disappointments. As a matter of fact, it's like people who are supposed to help you walk into your life, they don't walk out. You can't explain it. God is telling me there's a woman in your village, your father's son, an elderly woman, like I'm seeing an old woman, that in the next 72 hours, she will drop dead because power has jammed power. You are breaking forth after this meeting. Take it in the name of Jesus. Now, hear this. The Bible says that as soon as Zarah withdrew his hand, Pharaoh broke forth. Now, look at the question they asked. It touched me. Why that question? They said, how has that broken forth? That is what we are going to be dealing with that question tonight. How has that broken forth? Do you know there's some people right now, they want to be like you, they want to watch and follow the same way you are following now, they are sleeping. Some are trying to follow, but the sleep is hitting them. That is a demonic power that wants to manipulate them. Do you know that as soon as Pharaoh came out, they asked, how has that broken forth? There are some breakthroughs after this meeting. They will ask you, how did you get there? You are going to tell them, it is a breakthrough anointing. There's an anointing called forceful breakthrough. When it comes on your life, no power can stop you. The Bible says that Pharaoh came out and his brother came later and they called him Zarah. I will tell you the meaning of Pharaoh. I'm believing to those of you who have been connected, I told you Pharaoh means breakthrough. It means penetrating, dividing asunder every barrier and coming through to surprise the world. I want to see those who are angry at your following. Say this right now. I want to start saying this as we are following. Say this. I am angry. I am angry. It is enough. Enough is enough. Any of them begin to say it. I begin to release some fire to your family. Tonight I'm concentrating on your background. Because the battle of Pharaoh was in his background. Do you know they call him Pharaoh? They call him Pharaoh. Pharaoh. Breakthrough. This thing was not expected. We did not plan this for you, but you came out because you were uncomfortable. You were angry. You know his mother was an harlot. His mother played on harlot and gave birth to them. So he was angry. He was in a hurry to correct an error. His father committed incest. There are some things that were not too right in the background. You see, you are from that family because God wants you to correct the errors. You are not in that family by mistake. You are not where you are right now by mistake. No matter the battles of your life, there's a reason why God has to take you through there. But listen to me tonight. The powers that stop others cannot stop you. I'm speaking to you under grace that you cannot be stopped by the power that stop your father, the power that stop your mother, the power that stagnated your elders, the power that stagnated your yoga walls. Listen to me. Your case is different. Father said, my case is different. Do you know Zarah? Kalebo Shata. This is where we are going to pray. Kila Bayataba. Zarah, they gave him Zarah. Zarah means east. Zarah means east, where the sun rises. Lebrabo da Bayataba. Great battles come from the east. I want to tell you tonight, Silos. Major battles, I want to tell you. If you really want to handle major battles, you must handle the powers of the east. You know, that is where the sun rises. Check the Muslim community. They face the East. Check many, you know, demonic, occultic groups. They face the East. Why? That is where the battle is. Ah! Palende igamanunu jegejiki. Bang, 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 bang. Anywhere they have consulted the sun against you. Ah! Wherever they have gone to consult the moon, the sun, the stars, the elements to fight you. Tonight, I release aggressive angels against them. Native doctors consult the sun. Do you know what? Every power that is wicked, real wickedness, are done from the East. I'm telling you by revelation. I can show you in the Bible. I do read your Bible very well. When Pharaoh had a dream, one of the dreams was that he saw an east wind come and blew off some things that he saw in the dream. That prosperity. The east wind came. That is Genesis 41 verse 6. I want to read that place because we are dealing with the East right now. Zarah is a picture of Eastern powers. You know Zarah's hand prevented Pharaohs from coming out. I want to tell you the powers that prevent people from rising. The power that stagnate destinies. It was Zarah's hand that prevented Pharaohs from coming forth. Hear me well. If Zarah's hand had stayed there for 24 hours, Pharaohs would have not come out after that 24 hours. If Zarah's hand has been there for 2-3 days or 1 year, I'm telling you that Pharaohs would have remained in the womb. So the reason why you are delayed is because there is a hand, an evil hand, that is manipulating and tampering with your destiny. Lift up your right hand. Wherever you are right now, lift up your right hand. Say by fire, by thunder. Any power from the east fighting my destiny, any power from the sun, from the moon, from the stars, fighting and afflicting my destiny, your time is up. Right now, cash fire, cash fire, cash fire. Open your mouth. Pay tala, belega to Yamanda. Ebragada, bragada, 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 bragada. Any power from the east, power from the sun, power from the stars, power from the moon, afflicting my destiny, sitting on what belongs to me. Cash fire tonight in the name of Jesus. I'm seeing something in the realms of the spirit. Kabo yamate ko libalada yamande godaba. I just saw something like a native pot. It's like a native pot. It's like in a village, far, far. I don't understand it. I'm seeing some things like stars coming out of a native pot. I'm seeing stars right now coming out. The Holy Ghost is telling me that destinies are breaking out of cages tonight. Wherever they have buried your stars before, tonight, by this pressurized auction, you are coming out. To do death. The Bible says that Zarah's hand was out. In other words, preventing Pharaohs from coming. And Zarah means east, where the sun rises. Hear me well. The people fighting you are very intelligent. The powers fighting you are very intelligent. Apostle Paul said we are not ignorant of their devices. Christians are suffering because we don't want to know the secrets. We don't want to know. I came from a very rough family. Listen to me. If I tell you where I came from, you will know that I'm not just speaking. This is not a joke. I'm not talking of fans. I'm not giving you, you know, entertainment statement or message. I am telling you real life and real life battles. How do you overcome them? It's simple. It's by exposing yourself to things like this. You need to understand this. The day your destiny changes is the day you encounter revelation like this. Hear me well. The Muslims are running on a revelation they know. And listen to me, they are not just doing what they are doing. There's something behind them. You see, they're facing the East praying. You see other religious, demonic religious, they face the East. Some of their logos is like a part of the sun, a part of the moon, like a star. They know what they are doing because all these are from the East and they are dealing with powers. Hey, hear me well. Tonight, you are taking what is yours. I see people breaking forward. Ilabayata puhata. Tonight, I am so angry that I'm not really ready to take nonsense from the devil. We are taking what belongs to us tonight. That your marriage that has been delayed for years, tonight I activate it by the power of the Holy Ghost. That your car that has been taken from you in the realms of the spirit. You are supposed to be driving by now, but you are still trekking. Anytime you plan to buy a car, something happens to take your money. After this meeting, that demonic order fighting your prosperity scatters by fire. Rather, whatever God has ordained you to become, that they have denied you of, as a result of this encounter, you are becoming it double in the name of Jesus. I see angels dressing up people. I'm telling you, believe me tonight, because I'm speaking from the realms of the spirit. I see angels putting garments on people who are connected to this broadcast. There are people that will come in contact with this broadcast after we are through tonight, that will just go, that will just watch this. Just by coming in contact, the same anointing will hit them, because angels are at work everywhere. Mando loco subrate la bayata. Le kutube ila commande iziki palatola bayata. Wherever you are right now, I just feel like praying in tongues. Join me right now, wherever you are around the world. Let's pray in tongues for some seconds. Ki bale toyamanda. Le kiti zakida palakura mayamatutu kete kida. Ipale gaziya manenonda. Egbeng beng bong. Bung bung beng. Bila babeba. Zubigba. Bagbeng bula. Bigba. 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 Bolo bebe. Ziki. Zaka. Zaka. Ziki. Big bo bo. Zaka. Zaka. Ziki. Zaka. Be dolo do. Jakati yamanta. Be grade do. Pata. Do. Do. The powers from the east fighting my destiny. What are you waiting for? Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. Open your mouth. The powers from the east, the powers from my father's house, the powers from my mother's house, fighting my destiny. What are you waiting for? Cash fire, cash fire. Open your mouth now. Wherever you are, it is time. Back, da da da, chigidi, jagada, chigidi, jagada, chigidi, jagada, chigidi, jagada, chigidi, jagada, chigidi, jagada, chigidi, jagada. I am Balata. I see household demonic altars catching fire. As we are praying, wherever you are around the world, pray. It is time to set the holy altars on fire. Wherever they have taken a part of your body to, a part of your cloth, your pictures, your household names, it is time to set fire there. It is fire for fire tonight. Anywhere the powers of hell have summoned me, in the marine kingdom, in the occultic world, in the witchcraft cover, wherever, in the shrine, wherever, in the shrines of native daughters, let fire appear there. Holy Ghost fire, 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 Holy Ghost fire. I speak right now over everyone connected, wherever you are in the world, any evil altar fighting your children, fighting your job, fighting your destiny, any evil hand stretch out against your life, I command it. Cash fire, cash fire in the marine kingdom, in the witchcraft cover. Even there are some people here, some of your family wicked powers have gone from meeting tonight. God is telling me they will not return. The fire of God is roasting them. There shall be mass burials for witches and wizards. There shall be mass burials for native daughters. I speak as the son of the oracle, as a messenger of Christ. I speak in the name of Jesus Christ that wherever there is someone in your household, your destiny for evil, let fire scatter them. Power shabade kutayama. There is somebody watching right now who feel fire all over you. That is the power of the Holy Ghost. Right now, everything they planted in your body that is not of God, fire is catching them. They are catching fire and they are being roasted right now. You will hear in 24 hours a good news. I'm seeing you receiving a text message that you have gotten what you have been applying for. I see fire everywhere. I see it right now. I feel it all over me, all over this place. I just feel fire. This is not a just play. This is not catching fire. This is real business, because your destiny must shine. If you have read the book of Acts chapter 12, the scripture declares something. I love it. The book of Acts chapter 12. They all say, a man called Herod stretched forth his hand. He took James and killed him. And when he saw that he pleased the Jews, he went against him, stretched his hand, and took Peter. The church said, no way. You took James and killed him, but this, not this time. He stretched forth his hand. The church had to pray. The reason why they took your father is because there was no one like you standing up to take the challenge. I told myself, nobody in my family can send me out. No uncle, no cousin, no auntie, no whatever. They can't, because I have come to realize that destiny is a matter of violence. It's a matter of choice. You wake up and tell yourself, I will not fail. Brothers and sisters, I have broken through. You can break through. You can make it. This part of the devil. This is how it works. You wake up and tell yourself, no more. Others are waking up. Demonic powers in your villages are waking up before six. And they are speaking to the sun and the moon and the stars. And you are sleeping, thinking that everything can just work out like that. No! Jesus said, the children of this world are in their generation wiser than the children of light. They are wiser because they know how to address the elements of this world. The elements of this world are standing on powers. And you must address them. Jesus, on the mountain of transfiguration, a voice came to him and said, this is my beloved son, whom I well pleased. He said, hear ye him. So in other words, there was a command on all, there was an instruction to all the elements to hear him. So Jesus was to command the elements. He knew what to do. That's why he could tell the waves, stop. He commanded elements. So you must speak and address elements. The son can fight you if you don't know how to address it. Tonight, I'm speaking to you. As you are praying, elements are coming under divine alignment to favor you in the name of Jesus by the power of the Holy Ghost. If you have been summoned for evil, tonight we summon your summoners. Aha, you got it. Anywhere they have summoned you, the people that we hire to summon you in the realms of the spirit, the malams, the native doctors, the sagomas, whatever they call them, the angers, tonight fire scatters them. Wherever they are, whoever they are, that have been given an assignment to bring you down. The Bible said the king, in 2 Kings chapter 1, said to the soldier, he said, go and tell Elijah to come down quickly. To come. Bring, he said, bring the man of God. Go bring him. Then I said to the man, man of God, the king said, come down. The second group said, the king said, come down quickly. There are powers in your villages, in your communities calling you down. I came tonight in agreement with grace. By the power of the Holy Ghost, that you shall not come down. There's a person listening to this. It's like you have tried every attempt, you have done everything to secure something that looks like an admission, but you have not been able. I don't understand it, but God is telling me that after this encounter, the altar in your family that fights that breakthrough is broken to pieces. Go get that admission. Go get that job. Go get that thing you have been believing God for. Get it in the name of Jesus. Bible says, Aaron stretched forth his hand. I don't know where they have stretched their hand against you. You know, sometimes in the villages, they do something like this, you will see. That is an evil hand. I call it an evil hand. So they say, you will see. Now, I don't know where they have done that to you, that you will see, that your children will see, that you will come down, or that you will end up crying, begging your enemies. You hear me? They will be the one to beg you. You will not come down. I'm praying for that mercy listening. Everyone connected. The enemy's expectation over your life shall not stand. In the name of Jesus. Pray in tongues right now for 1 minute. As you are praying in tongues, you are saying, Holy Ghost, take over my destiny. Restore what the enemies have taken. Balako shata balata. Edegetu balika brakatoya. Leke subre eka balata. Listen to me right now. Wherever you are, if you are connected to what we are doing here, I want you to begin to say this. Wherever you are, begin to say this. I'm breaking forth. I'm breaking through. I must break through. In the name of Jesus, as you are saying that, you are speaking to the atmosphere. You are breaking through in the realms of the spirit, and you are addressing powers. You declare in the name of Jesus, I'm breaking forth. I am breaking through. I am a fairest generation. I am breaking through. No power can stop me. That job, I will get it. I will get my children. That battle in the court, I overcome it tonight. No matter the battles, that confessing and prophesying, you are breaking through. I see babies. I can hear the cry of babies in homes that have been barren for years. I can hear the sound of cars in people's garages. I can hear the sound of good news. I just hear a commotion of congratulations coming. That job, you have gotten it. That admission to school, you have gotten it. Yes, whatever you are believing God, I'm telling you, you have gotten it. Jesus said, he said that I've come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. The reason why Jesus came is for you to have life, not to have death. I reject death in the name of Jesus. I cancel that premature death. There's somebody who always dream of death. As a matter of fact, for the past 1 month, you have been bombarded with the spirit of death in your dream. You are just seeing different kinds of spirit chasing you, animals chasing you, and it's like you wake up, you are afraid. Hear me? That is it. Tonight marks the end of that oppression. I command that devil after you to catch fire in the name of Jesus. Palagado yamantaba. Hear me, because I'm going to be about to land, because it is the fire is too high. It's too high. If I continue like this, I may blow up here. It's too strong on me. The Holy Ghost is all over me. Hear me now. As you are there, the Holy Ghost is right there. Everything that you are believing God for, start agree with me. Start declaring them right now. Because things will be not as though they were. Abalako si Amanda. Gida baliko to bayata. Zubrekete palataba. The Bible says that Herod stretched forth his hand. There are evil hands. Listen to me. There are evil hands. You can be good to people, but when you turn your back, they do like this. You will see. You do everything to help your family, but they don't seem to understand that you are helping them. Because until you come down, they are not satisfied. All they want is for you to come down. Zarah stood in the way of Pharaoh. And Zarah means the east. Don't forget, I told you Zarah means east. It means east, the sunrise, where the sun rises. And that is where destinies are confronted, challenged, and limited, and stagnated, and manipulated. A man was seen flying in the plane, and he was not eating, he was just talking. And the man looked at him and said, "You are not eating, and you are just talking. Are you a Christian?" He said, "No." He said, "What do you do? Are you fasting?" He said, "Yes." He said, "What kind of fast are you fasting? You are not a Christian." He said, "You know, I'm from the kingdom of darkness. My job is to speak in the air, because while you are in the air, you have more privilege and more you have a better platform or in a better position to address powers." He said, we are on a mission to speak destruction of destinies, to speak division in families, to scatter people's lives and marriages. And the man that was talking to him, asking him the question, was a pastor. He was shocked that all believers can fast to destroy. Hamatabaya. In Acts chapter 23, some men came together and said they will not eat and drink until they have destroyed, killed Paul. These are people from the east, power from the east. They can go to any length to destroy. You give them money to help them, they take the money to an evil altar because they want to see your tears. I speak over your life. You will not cry. You will not die. But you will live to see the goodness of God in the land of the living. I declare over everyone connected, tonight marks the beginning of your breakthrough. I hear breakthrough. I hear breakthrough. I hear breakthrough. Breakthrough spiritually. Breakthroughs academically. Breakthroughs financially. Breakthroughs politically. Breakthroughs. Breakthroughs. I hear breakthroughs. Everywhere you are, begin to pray now. Begin to claim your breakthrough. Begin to claim it. I claim my breakthroughs. Begin to claim it right now. I give you seconds to claim your breakthrough. Whatever you say, God hears you and he will do it. Thou shalt also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and life shall shine on your way. Right now, begin to decree. I claim my breakthrough. In the name of Jesus, in my education, in my finances, I claim my breakthrough. In my ministry, everywhere, I claim my breakthrough. In the name of Jesus. Barakato Yamata. This is part one of this. Next week, Thursday, we are going to likely come up, because the revelation is too much to play with. We are dealing with powers here. You will break forth. You will break through, because you are going to make it a day to me every Thursday now. Even when I fail to come up, you must pray the prayer every Thursday. Make it a day with me. A day with God. A day with Jesus. And a day with the Holy Ghost. Because families, altars, fighting destinies must be destroyed. The scripture says, for this purpose, the Son of God was manifested. And he might destroy truth, this is where real destinies are decided. When you wake up like this and tell yourself, I will not suffer what my father suffered. What my mother suffered, I will not suffer. What my others suffered, I will not suffer. I'm going to be the one to break forth and lead the way for others to come out. It's possible, because with God, nothing shall be impossible. I'll tell you the truth. There are powers in the east that must be addressed for your destiny to break forth. Can we pray in tongues right now? Wherever you are, and I said before, if you can't pray in tongues, you don't know how to pray in tongues, all you just do is be shouting, Jesus, the blood of Jesus, Jesus. So I do it that you are hungry, you can receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost right now. Libala goto sabaya. Le graka da bale ku sabayata. Chiki chiki chika 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 laka chika laka chi. Iku laka tiki chaka laka. Egbo bo bagba igba bagbo. Begbo bo begbe big big bo. Elebe bubu begbe bo 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 be big bugba. Billy bugba bagba ba. Graka da big bugba. Shiki graka bugba big ba. Alaba yaba 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 yaba. Listen to me. You are going to get our number there. It's going to come up and it's going to be, you say there's a WhatsApp number you're going to actually have there. And it's going to come up there. I think the media will put it up right now. Our number, you can relate, you can set your prayer points. We want to be praying for you. We want to be praying for you. We want to be praying for you. We are people of prayer. My spiritual father is a man of prayer, Apostle John Suleiman, and God has given me that grace. I contacted the virus many years ago while I listened to his messages and listened to him and followed him everywhere, and that thing attacked me. I'm telling you, there is a grace to pray that God has given us. Anyone has come around me will tell you, we believe in prayer. The thing is raw. You cannot be the same again. Wherever you are, I release it to you, the virus of prayer. I release it to your spirit. Receive grace to pray. In the name of Jesus, you need to connect with us. Begin to find out how you can be in our meetings. Because when you come around an environment, the thing enters you. It's natural. Once you come into the company of a people of prayer, the thing naturally rubs off on you. And I want you to find out time. And with this Zimbabwe, look for how to connect with us and become a part of what God is doing. This is going to be the beginning of I Must Break Through. Thursday night with Paula Dukame. I'm telling you, you cannot be the same again. It is raw and it is fire for fire. Let Balata. I give you one scripture before I begin to pray to write up tonight. It is in the book of Ezekiel, Palibra Goda, dealing with the powers of the east. Ezekiel chapter 8, verse 16. Elabronda Balakotayanta. We are going to pray from here right now because the powers of the east, they stagnate, manipulate, and divert stars, destinies, and divine packages. And I'm telling you, you will wake up tonight to pray. Zobrakedaba. Ezekiel. Chapter 8. Please join me. My spirit, I'm just carried away. So if you are there, you can read the whole Bible. If not, just listen. Because something is happening in the realms of the spirit. Elebrahata. Ezekiel chapter 8. Lobrakedaba. Verse 6 says, And he brought me into the inner court of the Lord's house. And behold, and the door of the temple of the Lord, between the porch and the altar, were about 5 and 20 men, with their backs toward the temple of the Lord, and their faces toward the east, and worshipped the sun toward the east. It was specific, two times, the east, toward the east and the east. Why? That was where they were facing, worshiping the star, the sun. Next week, Thursday, we are going to continue from here because we are going to be dealing with the powers of the sun, the moon, and the stars. And I'm going to be revealing to you how God has taught me over the years that these powers are real. And you must follow every day between today and the next Thursday. Be preparing, be telling your friends about this. If you are going to watch this, try and share with your friends. Tell them there's a man of God they must listen to. Because this is not a man that is speaking, that is talking stories. This is raw and real. I came from a community and a family that was known for wickedness. And I'm telling you, I prayed for years. Even when I prayed, I was being beaten at night. I mean, 8 hours in tongues, fasting with aggression. And God told me, I'm taking you through this so you can teach you that there are powers you must deal with as a Christian. I have overcome them. God has helped me in life. And God, I have seen honor, I have seen favor, I have seen what God can do. But I'm telling you, that until I get to where God has ordained for me, I will not rest, because the altars of the wicked must always be confronted for greatness to come in, for breakthroughs unimaginable to come in. You are better than what you think you are right now. You are bigger than where you are right now. If only God can open up your spirit to get passionate and hungry and aggressive, you can break out of that limit to a new zone and a new dimension of life. And hear me well. These 25 elders were in the temple. They were a place that God supposed to be Lord. And they were facing the sun, evoking negative powers. Don't tell me that you will go to a church that believes in Jesus Christ, that believes in God. Thank God. But listen to me. There are churches that powers are aggressively, demonically oppressing people. And you must be aggressive yourself to break through such demonic embargoes. That is why there are people that will be in church for 20 years and they cannot explain why they are where they are. Life is dealing with them. Things are not working out. And they are wondering why. Because the devil does not fear you. He does not get scared of you carrying Bible. The devil is not worried about how many times you attend the service. He's worried about the fire of God in your life, by your commitment to God, your passion, your aggression when it comes to destiny. You cannot fail after now. The Bible says that Ezekiel was brought into the house and he saw these men and they were facing the sun, evoking the powers of the sun, the elements, and they were bringing destruction, evil to the house of God, to the people of God, to the people of God. Ah! Telepayata! That your wicked uncle. I'm speaking to somebody right now. You have done everything, fasted, prayed, did everything. It's as if the more you try to pray, the more their wickedness increases. God just spoke to me. That wicked uncle in your community, your family, that has stopped others because of you connected tonight, there's an angel of destruction assigned tonight to eliminate and frustrate and flush him out of your way. You are breaking forward in the name of Jesus. The Bible says Ezekiel saw it. Ezekiel saw it. And call it wickedness. Wickedness in the very house of God. Listen to me. The people fighting you are close to you. As a man of God, I am very, very aggressive in the place of prayer. Because when the devil wants to stop a man, he goes to people close to him. Listen to me. The person that wanted to stop Pharaoh was his brother. His brother. The people that sold Joseph were his brothers. The person that sold Jesus was his brother. Hear me. The people that will fight you most are those that know you, that those that are close to you. So you must be aggressive in the place of prayer. That is why Jesus always went to the mountain to pray alone. Jesus was always fasting, praying everywhere, because he knows the only way out is to be aggressive in the place of prayer. When I look at my bishop father, Apostle Joshua, I'm challenged to pray. After a meeting like this, you see the move of God. He goes to prayer. He said, the only one I trust, I know that he's going to help me no matter what, is God. He said, I will always be close to him. Listen to me. This is the right decision to make. A decision to pray. A decision to be close to God. Because even your personal assistant can be used by the devil to stagnate and manipulate your life. But when you are on fire, their missions cannot be completed. I speak over your life. Wherever you are connected, whoever is on assignment to truncate and destroy your destiny, tonight I flush them out of your way. By the power of the Holy Ghost, receive grace to fulfill your destiny. 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 I'm hearing God in my right ear. He said, tell somebody that the herald, of his or her destiny is dying tonight. In 24 hours, there are news coming to some people that the wicked people in your communities and in your family lives, they are dead. By the power of the Holy Ghost, listen to me. Herod, as soon as he stretched out his hand against Peter and the church prayed, that same chapter 12, the Bible says an angel of God struck him and he died. Wolves ate him up. That wicked person pursuing after your star, fighting against you. The same thing that happened to Herod in chapter 12 of Acts, it will happen to them. Because you are the anointed of God. Wherever you are, if you don't know Jesus Christ, listen to me, don't play with this, because it is highly corrosive. This is high tension power. It is highly, highly acidic. Whilst you are connected to this kind of prayer, you must know Jesus Christ. I'm telling something in my spirit right now. That somebody here tonight, an altar is catching fire physically, not in the spirit, physically. There's an altar that your picture you have been looking for one picture. There's a picture you have been looking for a long time. You have not seen that picture. Somebody took it from you and put it in an evil altar. That altar and the picture, they are on fire now, because whatever they have done against you is cancelled by fire. In the name of Jesus, wherever you are right now, begin to declare, I'm breaking through. I must break through. In the name of Jesus, Abaleko Shata, I am breaking through. I'm telling you, we cannot. We are coming more dangerously by the power of the Holy Ghost. Every Thursday, make it a day with Paul and Ogale. Tell your friends and your enemies. Tell them there's a man of God that is aggressive in the place of prayer that wants their breakthroughs. Sabato yikapila ko sashahata. Ligetu bali kriga tu dabaya bande kudabayata. Lebra gado bala kudabayata. E bali kude bali kraga do balata. Beleketu kabala kato kabaya. Legeto bale kusu braga daba. Now lift up your right hand wherever you are. You shout it at the top of your voice. Now don't hide your voice. Wherever you are around the world, just shout it. Powers of wickedness. Powers of wickedness. From my father's house. From my mother's house. From my place of work. In my residence. Wherever you are. Standing against my rising. My breakthroughs. Wherever you are. Evil altars. Wherever you are. Resisting my life. And my destiny. Cash fire. 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 Open your mouth. In the prayer, Balagada Bragadaba, cash fire, a Galagachuga, a Garagachuga,
Lugubele suzu jekibala tutuzaba.
You are at the verge of losing everything. That is what I'm hearing from God. You are at the verge of losing everything. Everything. Your name is like Margaret. I'm hearing God telling me that the battle is over. The yoke is broken. There's an altar because of you catching fire. You are free. By the power of the Holy Spirit. La boko shate libra da dabaya. Whoa, thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I have a few minutes. I'm going to be out of this place in some 2 minutes to one. Not more than one. I'm going to be out of this place. But I want you to know the prayer continues. Everywhere you are around the world, the prayer continues. Because you must take this thing home. That there are powers to address from the east. And today is just the beginning. We have not really gone into the real revelation. We are just dealing with Zarah. Power, the power that stops destinies. And these powers are always going to be called evoked from the east. And I'm telling you that when God is interested in your life, the devil will also take interest in you. The battles you are fighting are battles of destiny. And so what you do is to wake up like Jesus. He said, the prince of this world coming, he has nothing in me. He was always awake. Jesus, when he was to be taken, even when it was his destiny to be taken, he was not asleep. He was awake. Be awake. Wake up and pray. Address the powers that stopped others. And David said to his brethren, is there not a cause? Shammah, Abinadab, and the rest. He told them, there's a cause to do what I'm doing. If I don't do this, I believe that I'm going to end up the way others ended up. That is what we are doing tonight is the right thing. In the name of Jesus Christ, I plead the blood of Jesus over you right now. I plead the blood of Jesus over everyone that is connected to you. Hear me well, and hear me well, and hear me well, and hear me well, and hear me well. Sobra Geda Balata. My name is Paul Adogame, Omega Fire Ministries Zimbabwe, the son of Apostle Joseph Suleiman. Listen to me. God is doing amazing things in this nation, Zimbabwe. If you find out about us, we know that we are people of prayer. We have a place called Prayer City. And you need to find out how you can be connected because your destiny is online. Your destiny is online. Your destiny is online. The devil does not like you. And that is why God has anointed us to assist you into your destiny. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. Let's lift our hands and worship God tonight. Let's worship Jesus. For he is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Whatever he says stands. He opens the door and no one shuts it. And he shuts the door and no one opens it. I'm talking about Jesus Christ, the King of glory, the King of kings. He said, lift up your hands, so you guys are being here, lift up, and the King of glory shall come in. The King of glory is coming in, and everything is turning around for your good. I hear God in my ears. I'm hearing angels singing breakthroughs, 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 breakthroughs. So people will dream before 5 a.m. this night, and they are going to see people giving them packages. People giving them things in their revelation because you are collecting what they took from you. You are getting back what they took from your parents. What they took for years now, you are getting them back. I summon the angels to return what they took from you right now. In the name of Jesus. Palagade Zukabalata. Lebra Gadaba. The number is there once again. Get all the information you need to get about us. Omega Fire Ministries Zimbabwe. Paul Adogame. I'm on Facebook, as you see. And then I'm on Twitter. Coming up on Twitter. We are building up also on Periscope. You need to go to Twitter. Try to look for Paul Adogame. It's just a build-up we are doing right now. Very soon, it will also be on Periscope. Because I'm going to go on Periscope to also pray with people and also counsel and whatever God puts in my spirit to give to them. You need to connect. Do everything to connect because your destiny, as I said, by the Holy Spirit is online. And God has so much to give to you. You will not fail. Now, wherever you are, I cover you with the blood of Jesus Christ. Tonight, as you go to bed or as you sleep, as you rest, still pray. Some of you will just keep praying because the revelation you have received tonight will keep you praying in the spirit because you are getting back everything you have lost. But I tell you, you are under the blood. You are under the blood of Jesus. You are under the blood of Jesus. You are under the blood of Jesus. I'm hearing that in my spirit. You are under the blood. You are under the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Paul Adogame is my name once again. Find out where my meetings are around Zimbabwe and around the world. Listen, we have a strong crusade. I mean network, crusade network in Zimbabwe. a lot of places. Even today, Friday, I'm going to be preaching somewhere. We need to find out exactly how God is leading us for the liberation of mankind. I tell you, you are in for something unusual. It is unexplainable breakthroughs. God bless you. Have a wonderful night. In Jesus' mighty name. Follow all my posts. Go over and over. Like some of them. Just go through all my posts. Find out all the posts I've done over the time. And like them and go through them. Put them in your spirit. Because I do not just do a post. I do a post and God listening. They are prophetic words. They are statements given by God to release destinies. I'm going to be continuing on this message, on this prayer series, by Thursday, because we'll be talking about the generation of Perez. And Perez produced Ezra. Whatever. You see, I'm going to be dealing with that. The generation of Perez. And how we can release the fire of God to prepare the way for Perez generation to come. But we are not true. We are not true with dealing with the powers of the East. So watch out for that. Because we are dealing with the elements that manipulate destinies. I've heard God to tell, God is telling me to tell a woman, your husband is coming back home. He said, just write it down. Your husband left. The same way he left, they call his name out of your home. That the same way I'm hearing angels calling him back home. You will testify in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. So bracket.